sit down, let's celebrate this love we found. Hi lovelies, it's me, Simply Sherry, making home and entertaining simple. Today I am doing a collab video with Anne from Annie's Simple Life. Hi Anne, thanks for inviting me to this collab. She's also invited Rachel from Sweet and Simple Home and Patricia Keel. Please make sure to check out their videos and their channels. I'm sure you're gonna love them. They are all about having a decluttered home and living a simple life. I also know that Anne does some paleo recipes and Dollar Tree hauls. So for our collab, she has asked us to show a minimalist space in our home. I'm going to show you our updated guest room. A couple months ago, I showed it while it was in progress. If you wanna see that video, I'll put a link in the iCards above. The first thing I did was to paint the room the same color as I've been painting the rest of the house. It is a Dunn Edwards Miner's Dust. And then the next thing I did was to have someone come in and rip off the bamboo flooring that was glued to the concrete. It took a while, but he did an excellent job. And then he laid down this stick-on vinyl wood-like planks from the Home Depot line. It's really easy to clean and it just looks fabulous for so much less than having real wood. When you enter my home, the guest bedroom is to the left on the bottom floor. The family room is to the right along with the kitchen. And then to the left is the laundry room, the door to the garage, and the guest bathroom. What I love about the room is that it has these double doors. These are the floors that I was talking about, and I mean, I love them. Let me see, I got my pink socks on today. I love them. They're so easy to clean. They look fabulous from up close, and it just makes the difference in the room, don't you think? The corner that I think I showed on my Instagram feed, here is a trundle bed. So it's twin on top and twin underneath that we can pull out. And then this is the desk. The color palette I chose for the room is white, gray, and black. And the only color I have in here is this pop of yellow from these stems that I got from Hobby Lobby. So for the desk, I wanted it to be as clear as possible. And I also showed this on Instagram. The inside of the desk is not very deep or long, so can't fit that much, but there are some basic tools in here if the guest needs something, including earphones and some pens and post-it notes and a stapler. Here on the left is a thrifted milk glass cup that can hold their keys or change. Right now there's gift cards that Cicely got from her friends for Christmas that she still has to use. And then I love this lamp. I had another lamp and it actually broke. So it was LED and you can't change out the LED. You have to buy a whole new lamp. And I did some research on Amazon and I just thought that was interesting because I was like, someone help me change this light bulb, but I guess I can't. So I definitely got one that is for a CFL. And I love this. It's like a take on a vintage pharmacy lamp. So you see this handle, you lift this handle and then the lamp moves down or up if you want the light to go closer to whatever you're reading or writing here on this desk. Then I have this sign from Hobby Lobby and I've had this rack, and what I've done is to put a guest book here where they can sign it. And then I just have this flyer. My husband and I did a fundraiser a while back of this documentary called Blood Brother. It's on Netflix. I highly suggest it. One thing I've always liked to do is to put the Wi-Fi password in the guest room so that they know what it is. So here I just printed out this sign and Cicely laminated it. I have it covered right now, but our Wi-Fi there is there and the password. And then Cicely made this terrarium. Then here is the chair where I've just put a pillow behind it. There's the trash. And then I do have a humidifier in the room because it does get very dry here. It's actually awesome. It really makes a difference in the room. These two pillows are pillow covers actually, like $3 each, and then from Amazon. And then Cicely let me use one of her little pug stuffed animals just to make it a little bit more homey. This quilt I've had forever. I just keep the pillow there and the blanket so it's ready to go. And then you can see here that whoever is sleeping up here does have space to step down And then you can see the space that they have to put their luggage. Here in this corner, I just have my clock, some magnolia stems, my little white dachshund I got from Target. Now this is a computer and it's touchscreen. And so they can either, you know, surf the internet, check email while they're here, and definitely watch Netflix or Hulu. So I don't mention it very much, but I was a missionary to the Philippines for 10 years. And so this was the group that we were overseeing, and they signed all their names. It was very, very special to me and to my husband. That is the connecting door to the full bath. They're nice and sturdy. I like the brown wood there. And then they're just empty cubbies. I thought if they want to put clothes in here or bags, shoes even, they can put it in there. So there's three empty ones. And then this one is where I keep extra toiletries, tissues, these mason jars holding toiletries in them. Oh, that's a scrub that Cicely and I had made, things for your nails. Here's an extra washcloth. This is a closet right now, and then some hangers, pants hangers. I've had for a long time. It's bulky. It's not very functional. Let's just say that. But so I wanted to try to keep this, and then I tried to salvage it by putting this Martha Stewart wallpaper on there. I think it's Martha Stewart, but you get it from Target. It's a beautiful wallpaper. I actually wanted to do the wall behind me with this paper, but it was more trouble than I had expected. So here's a tray that I fill up with goodies before my guests come. And I still have this for hot chocolate because it is winter time. These are melanine, so they don't break necessarily, with some coasters. I put goodies here like gum. I do put a couple bottled water there. They're not allergic to nuts. I'll put nuts, chips, cookies, you know, just stuff that, you know, late at night, don't you get the munchies? So I want to make sure that my guests are covered as far as having those midnight cravings. But it fits perfectly into my closet, so that's why I'm keeping it for now. If they use packing cubes, I think this is a perfect place to put packing cubes. And then this is the foam mat for the bathroom. This is a wire basket where I've just put their towels, and I think I've put a set of four bath towels here and four hand towels. So I just pulled out the decal from the laundry room, and Cicely definitely helped me. She helps me with probably about 40% of the decluttering, organizing, and different projects that we have in our house. We use this kind of like a couch during the day. Cicely and I lounge in here. This is where we have our sleepovers, and you know, we do our nails here. So with the bed pushed to the corner, I thought it worked out as far as the decal to have one here and have it kind of go across the bed and the wall. So it's not covering the whole wall there, and it's not covering the whole wall here. I hope you guys like this video of our updated guest bedroom. Please make sure to check out Anne's, Rachel's, and Patricia's video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye. Your love so sweet, your heart, my sweet potato pie.